Good morning. Welcome to this service here this morning, the seventh Sunday after Trinity. I greet you with the watchword. You are no longer foreigners and aliens, but fellow citizens with God's people and members of God's household. As I say, welcome to the service here this morning, and I would just like to make the following announcement. Our next service for the coastal parish will be on Sunday. It's a fifth Sunday, so there's only one service here at 8:30 at St. Andrew's with Children's Ministry. Then Bettina and myself are away from Thursday and we'll be back on Sunday. We'll be away on the church council meeting in Cape Town. Just a reminder that there's still meat left from the food market that is frozen. If you would like some, please contact myself, Bettina, or Vera. Then the following people are on our prayer list. Tilla Kosagen, Helena Meister, Dean van der Venter, Daniel Hoyer, Michael Berger. Those are the people on the prayer list. The seventh Sunday of the Trinity is all about fellowship, about communion. It's also about Holy Communion. In our epistle reading, which is our sermon text for today, we'll hear about the life of the first congregation. In our gospel reading, we hear how Jesus is the provider and provides 5,000 people with enough to eat. The theme that runs through the service is God brings us together, and in his presence there is abundance. I ask you please to stand and let us speak our gathering sentences. Come, the banquet of hope and praise is ready.
We come on your invitation, seeking to be fed.
Feed on the love of God and Jesus Christ.
We come on your invitation, needing healing.
Be healed by God's gracious mercy.
We come on your invitation, longing for forgiveness.
In Jesus' name, you are loved, healed, and forgiven.
Hallelujah. Praise be to God.
We celebrate the service in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You may be seated. Can the children come to the front? I want you to help us to sing the first hymn. Our first hymn that we want to sing together. Let us stand for this hymn. Let us sing together, Father, speak your word again. You as children can stay in front. Morning. You energized. Let me still pray for you. Heavenly Father, where your children go, and I ask that you speak your word to them, that when they hear your love, Lord, I ask that you bless their time, and they learn and grow in you as their Lord and Savior. And the blessing of God, the Father, God, the Son, God, the Holy Spirit, be upon you. Amen. You can take the cake.
I love it.
Byron, you can take the candle today. Let us now turn to the Lord and let us praise God with words from Psalm 107. I give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Those he redeemed from trouble and gathered in from the lands, from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south.
Some wandered a desert waste, finding no way to an inhabited town. Hungry and thirsty, their soul fainted within them.
Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them from their distress. He led them by a straight way, until they reached an inhabited town.
Let them thank the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wonderful works to humankind. Eternal God, maker of heaven and skies above, lowly Christ, lover of the earth and its people, unfretted spirit, giver of gracious gifts.
You are present with us.
O hidden mystery, sun behind all suns, soul within all souls, in all we touch and all we need.
You are present among us.
As bearers of your image, we come to be reshaped.
Dependent on your mercy, we ask you to be made new.
For the right roads we avoid travelling, and the kindly words we refuse to share. For the false God who receive our worship, and the true selves we have starved of love, God, by your grace.
Forgive us.
For the hidden hurts we hold, that we've held too tightly, and the promises which we've never kept. For the careless use of our time and money, and the lame excuses we should have never made, God, by your grace.
Forgive us.
For all we should be, and all we can amend, God, in your love.
Redeem us.
For all you have in store for us, and all you may demand of us, God, in your love.
Redeem us.
For the life of the world, for the love of its people, God, in your love.
Amen.
God, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. God, have mercy on us. Hear and believe these words of Jesus Christ. Your sins are forgiven. Go in peace. Come and follow me. Glory to the Creator who gives us life. Glory to Jesus, whose love remakes us. Glory to the Spirit, companion on our journey. Glory be to God. Amen. Let us praise God by singing, "Praise my soul, the King of Heaven." Everlasting King, we turn to you and we ask you Feed us now, Jesus, Son of God, as you fed your first disciples. Feed us with that soul food which nurtures enough love within us to outstrip the fears that ties up the world in us. Feed us with that spiritual bread that strengthens our hands for serving those broken and lost people of this world. Feed us so that we may be fulfilled with some of that joy that the universe cannot contain. We ask this in your name, Lord Jesus Christ, for you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Let us sing our next hymn, Hand in Hand, verses 1, 2, and 4.
Chapter 6 of the Gospel according to St. John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus went to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, also called the Sea of Tiberias. A large crowd kept following him because they saw the signs that he was doing for the sick. Jesus went up the mountain and sat down there with his disciples. Now the Passover, the festival of the Jews, was near. When he looked up and saw a large crowd coming toward him, Jesus said to Philip, "Where are we to buy bread for these people to eat?" He said this to test him, for he knew himself what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 6 months' wages would not buy enough bread for each of them to get a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what are they among so many people?" Jesus said, "Make the people sit down." Now there was a great deal of grass in the place, so they sat down, about 5,000 in all. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who were seated, so also the fish, as much as they wanted. When they were satisfied, he told his disciples, "Gather up the fragments left over, so that nothing may be lost." So they gathered them up, and from the fragments of the 5 barley loaves left by those who had eaten, they filled 12 baskets. When the people saw the sign that he had done, they began to say, "This is indeed the prophet who is to come into the world." When Jesus realized that they were about to come and take him by force to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain by himself. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, O Christ.
Let us, with Christians around the world, confess our faith in God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, by speaking together words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day
Lord Jesus Christ, and beloved of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, now be with you all. Amen. You may be seated. Dear fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, our sermon text for this Sunday is written in the Acts of Apostles, and I read from chapter 2, beginning at verse 42. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching, and to fellowship, and to the breaking of bread, and to prayer. Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles. All believers were together, and they had everything in common. They sold property and possessions to give to anyone who had a need. Every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes. They ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. So hear the word of God. Let us become still in the presence of God. Let us pray. Jesus Christ, you are the bread of heaven. We ask that you come down, that you come and fill us with your Spirit, because your Spirit satisfies like none other. We hunger and thirst for you this morning. We long for you to nurture us in your love and your forgiveness. So we come to the sacred time and place, where our hunger is finally and fully satisfied, as only your bread can do. We will wait and we will listen for your voice. Amen. Dear friends in Christ, this morning I've brought along a pack of colouring in pencils. Think of the following scenario. Say I would take one of these pencils out, and I would give it to a child, give him a blue pencil, and I would say to the child, please draw me a colourful drawing. But I only give him one pencil. I think the child will look at me if this pastor has gone totally crazy. See, one pencil cannot make a beautiful, colourful drawing. It needs to be part of a pack. If one colour is missing, the drawing will not be complete. Each one of us is like a colouring in pencil. There are a lot of things that we can do and can accomplish by ourselves, but faith is not one of them. We cannot follow Jesus as an individual. Faith is never just a private matter that happens in my home. It is impossible to follow Jesus Christ as a disciple alone. Jesus, throughout his ministry, taught his disciples what it meant to be together. Disciples are not meant to exist in isolation. Just like a specific colouring in pencil is not meant to be alone, but part of a pack. Jesus, in our sermon text this morning, reminds us that we are his modern-day followers, and we can also not exist on our own. We are part of a pack, a faith community of brothers and sisters, and we are brought together by grace. We as a faith community belong to one another only through and in Christ. We as a faith community belong to one another only through and in Christ. That means then that Jesus Christ is the center of the local faith community, the congregation and the universal church. That means that when I belong to his congregation, it's not what I just get out of it. It is not how much I can consume. It is not about my wishes. A congregation is also not a closed social exclusive cultural club. We're realizing that a congregation is not about the I. Rather, in the community of believers of St. Andrew's, it is about Jesus, about his congregation, where he is the heart and the center of our community and the universal church. Thus, we are one together by grace, even though we are created uniquely by God, our Father. We are called to be a community by Jesus Christ. And Jesus, through our sermon text today, wants to show us a few aspects of a community of believers that are important. Worship, fellowship, breaking of a bread, and prayer. Those are key elements in a Christian community, key aspects. Let us now look a bit more closely at these aspects. The first aspect of a community together by grace is that of apostles' teaching. Back to my colouring in pencil. A pencil cannot hold itself to be used to colour, and it needs to be held. And the same is also true for us. We are to be held by God, our Father, who guides and leads us in our life. God leads and guides us through his living, loving word to us as a community. As a community, we are gathered together by grace so that God can serve us through his word, revealing to us that we need our Savior Jesus Christ, who saves us through mercy and his forgiveness. And then as a faith community, we respond to God serving us by worshiping Jesus, who is the heart of our life and his faith community, who lovingly holds us in his divine hands to guide and lead us through our life. The second aspect of a community together by grace is that of fellowship. If we take a colouring in pencil and we start colouring in, we notice it leaves a mark on the drawing. We as a community are to leave a positive mark in each other's life. We are called to fellowship. Fellowship entails being present, being active, being focused on one another as God's family. If you are missing in the life of a faith community, there will be a gap. Because we are called, each one of us, no one excluded, to leave a positive mark in someone's life. We leave a positive mark in someone's life when we listen to each other, when we take time for each other, when we care for each other, and when we help carry a bit of a heartache of a fellow member who's going through a difficult time. We also leave a valuable mark in the faith community through using special gifts that Jesus has entrusted to each one of us as his faithful disciples. As a faith community, we are gathered together by grace. We are gathered together to support one another through the gifts that Jesus has entrusted to each one of us. The third aspect of a community together by grace is that of breaking the bread. Sometimes enough, it happens when we're busy colouring in, but we make a mistake and then we need to take the razor and erase that mistake. The breaking of bread reminds us of a special gift of Holy Communion that we want to celebrate just now, and we want to do it as often as we can in remembrance of Jesus. Holy Communion is a wonderful sign to us as a faith community that Jesus Christ has erased all our sin, as individuals, but also as a community. Holy Communion is a wonderful sign to us as a faith community that we always receive the forgiveness, the grace, from Jesus alone. It's nothing that we can do to earn it. Holy Communion is a wonderful sign to us as a faith community that Jesus Christ also wants to strengthen us in faith and in love so that we can be his light to the people around us. As a faith community, when we are gathered together by grace and in the breaking of bread, we experience the grace then of our gracious host, Jesus Christ himself. The last aspect of a community together in grace is that of prayer. Looking at this pack of pencils held together by this rubber band, we see a multitude of colors. All these colors can help to bring wonderful color to a drawing. Prayer, on the other hand, also brings color into the life of a faith community. We are called to pray for the world in which we live, for one another, but also for ourselves. Through prayer, something special happens. We turn our eyes away from our situation, from our abilities, and we turn our eyes to Jesus Christ, who wants to take time for us, who wants to hear what is on our heart. We turn to Jesus, whose colorful promise gives us hope as Jesus remains with us through all the different facets of life as a community. Through prayer, we put ourselves into the hands of Jesus Christ, and we realize then that we are indeed dependent on him as our teacher, as our sustainer, as our guide, as our protector. As a faith community gathered together by grace and prayer, we realize that Jesus remains with us and we are dependent on him. Dear friends in Christ, in conclusion, we realize then that as a disciple of Jesus, we cannot follow Jesus by a lonesome self, nor can we see faith just as a simple private matter that happens at home. No, because Jesus Christ has gathered us and placed each one of us in a particular faith community of which he is the very center, the very heart. That faith community belongs to him. We are all equal. Jesus knows all too well we need one another through love. We need to be together. Therefore, we realize then that together we are better by his grace. Together we are better by his grace. May we, as the faith community of St. Andrew's, be held in the hands of Jesus to serve us, to teach us, to guide us through his word. May we as a faith community of St. Andrew's, through Jesus' help, leave a mark of fellowship in each other's lives to be there for one another. May we as a faith community of St. Andrew's, when we break bread together, be reminded of the grace of Jesus Christ that erases our sin. May we at St. Andrew's be a praying community that is strengthened through the colorful hope that Jesus Christ gives us, that he hears us, that he sees us, that he takes notice of us, and remains with us to guide us as his faith community there where he has placed us. And the peace of God which transcends all our understanding, may guard your hearts and minds in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Dear fellow brothers and sisters, let us now sing our next hymn. And it's called, O God in Christ You Call Us. And it's on the melody, The Church Is One Foundation. We want to sing four verses. gather here this morning at God's table, some empty, some filled, some whole, some broken, yearning for the Holy Spirit to fill us. We come with one another. We come with those who have shown us the way, trusting that God will continue to illumine our hearts. We surround the table of grace so that we might be fed with the bread of life, that grace we may serve others, that healed we may bring hope into this world. Let us now turn to our Father in the prayer of praise. Holy God, you alone are holy, you alone are the true God. The universe declares your praise beyond the stars, beneath the sea. Within each soul, within each breath, we praise you, God Almighty. Generations bless your faithfulness through the water by day and by night, through the wilderness, out of exile into the future. We bless you, O God Almighty. We give you thanks for your dear Son, the heart of human life, near to all those who suffer, beside the sinner, among the poor, with us now. We thank you, O God of Almighty. We remember the way that you showed your love to us, our Heavenly Father, that on that night, our Lord Jesus Christ, when he was betrayed, he took the bread, and when he given thanks, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way he took the cup after the supper. When he given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink of it, all of you. This is the new covenant of my blood, which is spilled for you, for the forgiveness of sins. Do it as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Heavenly Father, send the power of your Holy Spirit upon the gifts of bread and wine, O God, that we may experience the presence of the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ. Breathe your Spirit in us, that we may be one body with him, living out his ministry in this world and every day. And we end this prayer with the words of our Lord who taught us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, come to the table of the Lord, have fellowship with him, but also fellowship with your fellow brothers and sisters. Come, everything is ready. You may be seated. Pharaoh will direct you to the front. Life-sustaining Father, thank you for sending your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to be the bread of this world. You give us what we need for our bodies, for our souls, and for this we give you thanks and glorify your name. We pray that you feed us with the knowledge of Christ so that we may recognize you here in this place and also place our trust in you. Heavenly Father, it is easy for us to go through the motions of spirituality. We want to say the right prayers and think that we have found the magical keys that make holiness appear in our lives. And yet we are still empty, Lord. We hunger, we thirst for something that will sustain us through all times in our life. We chase after things that will disappoint, hurt, and yet we look past the very thing that will heal and cleanse our life. Jesus Christ is your bread of life, the manna from heaven, which was and is sent to feed and sustain us in all the wilderness through which we travel. Help us to stop running after the glitz and the glitter, the easy wealth. Help us to look truly for one who will quench our thirst and nourish our souls. Lord, you call us to be a praying community, and so we ask you for your care and your healing touch for those who are sick. We ask for your compassion on those who are suffering in this world. We ask for your comfort for those who are grieving. You call us all as a community to break bread together, which we have done. We have received this wonderful gift of bread and wine. May we truly be reminded that Jesus Christ unites us, nurtures us, feeds us. And now that we've been nourished, may we go here from this place of community in renewed commitment to serve you one another and the world in which you have placed us. We pray this in your holy name. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, may the love of God, which gives life to the world, sustain you. May the bread of life, Jesus Christ, feed you with a food that endures to eternal life. May the power of the Holy Spirit nourish and strengthen you in faith. Therefore, receive the blessing of God. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favour and give you his peace. Amen. Let us remain standing for the last hymn that we want to sing together, with which we want to end the service. May we be one.